We're here in Milwaukee on location with Norman Jewison's new picture called Gaily Gaily, and one of its stars, Mr. Hume Cronin. Hume, what is it about this picture that excites you?
Well, not the sound of that saw in the background. Sorry. They're building a set back there, so you've got to compete with that.
Okay.
What does it excite me? Well, it's exciting to do a film again. I haven't done one for 5 or 6 years. I was very anxious to work with Norman Jewison.
This is your first time to work with him,
yes,
I take it.
Yes, and it'll come as a surprise to possibly to any actors see this, that the way I got the job was to pick up the telephone and call him and say, I would like to work in your new film, or almost that.
Did you have a particular role in mind? Did you know that much about the picture?
No, this is how it happened. It was not my agent. I have an agent I'm very fond of, but he had nothing to do with this. I had heard that Abe Guinness, who wrote the screenplay, had been at the Forum and had seen me playing in The Miser. And he'd said to a friend of mine in the cast that there was something in the film that he thought I ought to do. And she, being very much on the ball, let 6 weeks go by before she told me anything about this. However, I knew Abe Guinness. I'd met him, and I called him up and said, you know, is it true? Is there something? And he said, yes, as a matter of fact, there is, but I have nothing to do with the casting. I mean, authors, you know, are particularly careful not to intrude on what is the director's prerogative. So I'd never met Jewison, but I thought, what can I lose? All he can do is say no. So I called him up and said, I'd seen this, and was there any chance of it? And that I'd invited him to come to the play, but he'd been off on location somewhere. He'd been out scouting these locations. He was here in Milwaukee at the time. He said, no, I wasn't able to see it, but will you come and talk to me? And he said, and I'll send you a script right now so that you can read it, and when we come together and we can talk about it, you'll know what it's all about. And so on. And it was just as simple as that.
And so what kind of a
role? It doesn't always happen that way.
What kind of a role is it here?
I'm playing a character called Honest Tim Grogan, who has a heart full of larceny and a great deal of Irish blarney.
Sounds like
and,
a lot of
fun. He's also referred to as the last of the big city bosses.
We know, of course, that...
It's the Chicago political machine, about 1910.
Well, and this, of course, when will it come out? It won't come out yet in 68.
I don't know. Oh, I don't think that would be possible. Can anybody tell me when this will come out? Sometime in 1969, would it? I think probably. See, no one's going to commit themselves to that. See, I got dead silence by way of an answer.
Hume Cronin, thank you very much for talking with
us
today.
I've enjoyed it.
The best
you.
Of luck to you in Gaily Gaily. And
thank
this
you.
Is Bobby Wygant in Milwaukee on location with Norman Jewison's new picture, Gaily Gaily, for United Artists and the Mirisch Company. Till next time, then. Bye-bye.